the exams. Now, when that happens, you frustrate students who are ready and trying to recall, especially when they have looked at the questions. It frustrates them. And so that should be avoided. Then avoid giving hints to students who ask about individual items. And this is very, 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 very possible. Some students will raise their hands. You go there and they ask, "Sir, it appears this particular question, there is no answer. It appears this particular question is wrong. It appears this is not supposed to be there." A word of caution is that avoid discussing questions with individual examinees. And so what is best to do is that if there are ambiguities, if there are things that need to be clarified, if there are corrections that needs to be made, it is important that you take the microphone or you do it in a general form so that everyone will hear, to ensure that there is fairness in the testing process. Lastly, expect and prepare for emergencies. And emergencies can include people coming to the examination hall, examinees coming to the examination hall and they are sick. There may be power outages. You need to envisage, you need to look at, project some of these challenges and think about them and look at how best you can really tackle them when they happen. Because sometimes you don't think about them, so when you go and it happens, it becomes a problem. This is EDCR 361, Measurement, Evaluation, Statistics discussion on guiding principles for test administration. We gave about 16 of the principles. They might not be exhaustive. When you read other books, you may get other ones. And we believe that the discussion was very good. We spoke about what goes into test administration, and we said the physical environment, the psychological environment plays a critical role. And we took our time to talk about the do's and don'ts and everything that needs to be done right when administering a test to a group of students. We'll pause here for some few minutes and take our questions or comments or suggestions. Our TV test studio line is 0503-923158. 0503-923158. It is the same line for WhatsApp and SMS.
Okay, so the studio is activated for interactive session. Call in 0503-923-1158. Same line. You can text and also WhatsApp your comments. Then you can also send your message through the Facebook section, Radio Windy Bay 98.3 FM. We wait on your questions and comments. Thank you.
Windy Bay 98.3 FM.
Okay, so for opportunity of those who didn't have a full lecture this morning, we may just have to recap what we did this morning. So the whole of this morning, we're talking about principles that we need to put in place in administering our test. We went through the process of understanding what it means to administer a test. And we said it is a psychological and a physical setting of the test or how people to take the test. And we took the lesson through some processes or some conditions that we need to do, the do's and the don'ts. We talk about that you need to prepare your student for the test. It's very important before you even start the whole process, psychologically prepare them for the test, where you have to talk about the timing, the date, the conditions, the type of the test they are going to write, and the nature of the test. We talked about that. And we talked about the fact that make students aware about the rules and regulations guiding the whole testing processes. That will also guide them on how to prepare towards the exams. We talk about the fact that we need to also avoid giving tests to students just after vacation or before vacation. Long ones, of course, it doesn't help the student to prepare well for the exams. Then we talk about the fact that we have to also avoid giving tests to students when they should be doing something at their own pleasure times or times that are not favorable for exams, where we set an example that you don't set questions and ask them to come 25th December to write the exams. They might not turn up, and this will be a disaster for you. Sitting arrangement, we touched about that, that it should be well arranged and be well arranged for students to be able to write the exams so that it will eliminate some of the issues. Then we talk about the fact that have provisions or make provision for extra sheets where students have to wait for 15 to 20 minutes before the sheets arrives. Sometimes you're not going to the printing press to get extra sheets before you return. Students might have even forgotten what they need to write. And the anxiety that he's feeling alone might not even make him write again. And this will not be good for your student. Announcements should be made at regular intervals. If it is 30 minutes, after every 30 minutes, you tell your student, You don't start and say, you've started 5 minutes gone, 20 minutes gone. No, it distracts the whole process. And that will not encourage you to get good testing environment. Frank will also go through the rest that we've gone through.
So we have talked about a lot. And I remember mentioning that we need to avoid threatening statements. Some legislators will tell you, your time is going. Mm-hmm. You sit there, your time is going. By the time you realize, your time will be up. Some legislators, when they say start to work and they see you sitting, why are you sitting? We have already started the work and we have spent about 15 minutes. You are still sitting now. What are you? Do you want to fail? All these are comments that are cautioned against. As much as possible, we said that as much as possible, you need to avoid distractions within the environment, whether created by some students, whether created by some invigilators, whether created by those who are passing by, or anybody outside the testing or immediate to the testing environment, we need to do that. And we mentioned that it will be helpful to hang things like do not disturb testing in progress, exams in progress, and they all help. Perhaps we can do that and put that at the door of the examination. Then we need to avoid testing anxiety. Most of the things we have talked about, it touches on the anxiousness of the examinees. So warnings should be avoided. Then telling students to be working fast because there is no time. Then telling them if you fail, you can't progress to other levels of education. If you fail, you won't get a job. That is not a platform where such motivating or encouraging messages are required. Talking unnecessarily in the examination hall should be avoided. Then avoid giving hints to students or discussing items with individual examinees. And at best, if ambiguous questions should be clarified, it should be done in the general form, and everybody should be in the hearing. We ended our guiding principles with that you should expect and prepare for emergencies. For example, examinees come to the examination hall and they will be ill suddenly. Question papers should be printed in excess. So it is not too good that when you have about 200 students, you print 200 questions. Sometimes you go and you realize that some of the questions are missing for some of the sheets. What then happens? Then it means that you need to run back to either the office or the examination units to print some of the questions. And sometimes we keep such students waiting. And it creates a lot of anxiety for them. Answer booklets should be in excess. We should bear in mind that there can be power outages during an examination situation. Our studio line is activated 0503-923158, 0503-923158. It's the same line for WhatsApp and SMS. We can also take comments from Facebook, Radio Windy Bay 90.3 FM.
live here in the studios of Radio Winnie Bay 98.3 FM. Live here in the studios of Radio Winnie Bay 98.3 FM.
We have a question through SMS from Sly Ejimakwu Campus, and I want to believe the person is in any of the departments doing languages. Sly is asking, please, with exams which are conducted mostly before vacation and sometimes before holidays, what is your advice regarding this occurrence? Thank you. Please, with exams which are mostly conducted before vacation and sometimes before holidays, what is your advice regarding this occurrence? Thank you. So, Sly, your question is very relevant, and we thank you so much for this. What we need to bear in mind that as teachers or potential teachers or as educators, as stakeholders, testing is not done because we want to perhaps find grades for students, or because we are teaching students, we need to test them. testing is done to for a specific purpose, and particularly in our setting, we do tests to examine how well students that we are preparing are prepared, how well students have a mastery or a grasp of whatever has been taught to them over a period of time. We are assessing you because we also want to assess ourselves as instructors and as facilitators. So there is a reason why, there is a purpose why we test. And if that is supposed to be done and done well, then it is important that it is done devoid of every distraction, devoid of